सदाशिव समारंभाम शंकराचार्य मध्यमाम अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंताम वंदे गुरु परंपराम श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानाम आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मीति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणं विदधाति पूर्वं यो एतादृश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंहदेवमात्मप्रकाशं मुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्री चिद्घनगणेशान्मोह्यं सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयोः अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दुःखत्वनिर्मूलम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहन्नमत्वन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। Let's look at the questions yesterday. Let's do some recap. There were some questions after the Patha yesterday. this is, as I said, it's a little complicated section because we have looked at the other pakshas. Just a moment, please. So we looked at the other pakshas as to what are the misconceptions in khyati. How does, and khyati, the word khyati means knowledge. Contextually, it means brahmajnana. Just a moment, please, sir. So contextually, khyati means jnana in the brahmasthala. Rajju sarpa jnana is khyati. How to explain this sarpa jnana and sarpa being seen? So sarpa as a padartha, whether it exists or not. If it exists, what is its reality? And what is the jnana that takes place in the antarkaran? So that's the khyati vada. Various people explain it variously. So we have to understand the Siddhanta at least. And to understand the Siddhanta, we have to see what the other pakshas say. And other pakshas are basically erroneous conclusions. Ramchandranji, kindly switch off your video. So what happens is the Purvapakshi's view need not be, you know, Tarkika's view or Vaisheshika's view or whosoever views. We don't care whose view it is. That's a technicality. What we need to know is what it is not. And these are the ideas which are there in the buddhi, because buddhi antakarana has a tendency to overthink everything. And unless one has clarity, one cannot get nishtha. Thereby, the antakarana also should be satisfied. The buddhi should be satisfied, without which there is no sthira jnana. Thereby, these purvapakshas are seen. So, one, we have to understand the Siddhanta, at least at a level where there are no questions. Second, we have to know what they are not, what the reality isn't. And in the end, if there are questions, we have to go at the granular level. And in this book, we have seen this is what the book itself is called. The text is called as, Grantha is called as Vichara Sagara. It is the Vichara Sagara. So you cannot miss anything in this sagara. It will go deep into each and every point and analyze it. Now those who do not get the depth of it, it is fine. As long as you do not have confusions and questions. But looking at the questions, I feel that there are details which are missing. Because most of the other prakrana granthas, especially without the tika, they deal at a superficial level, which is sufficient. And the some acharyas do not handle the depth because of the varied audience. So audience is such that they cannot go into such depth, qualification lacking. Some people do not have language skills, others do not know mimamsa. Third, most of them don't have any tarka background. You cannot go in depth. But this is all based on Vedanta Paribhasha. Those who have studied Vedanta Paribhasha, they should have absolutely no difficulty. But Vedanta Paribhasha itself is a complicated grantha, though a basic grantha in Vedanta. Basic text in Vedanta is not Tattvabodha. Tattvabodha is absolutely bare minimum. It is a nursery level text. It is not even a kindergarten level text. It is a nursery level text. One needs at least Vedanta Sara. Vedanta Sara, just give me another moment, please, sir. Sorry, some hiccups today. So, Vedanta Sara uses some tarka there. Tattvabodha has barely any tarka. Whereas Vedanta Sara uses tarka. We cannot do away with tarka completely. We should be able to make viveka between tarka as a philosophical grantha, darshana, and tarka as a logical system. You cannot throw away the baby with the bath water. Tarka is extremely important. It is very simple. Without tarka, there is no moksha possible. Because manana is right there in the Shruti. We cannot misinterpret manana any which way, you know. Manana is going to use tarka, whether you like it or not. Jnana, see, there is no jnana. Jnana itself is a tarka process. You cannot have jnana, just someone says something and you understood it. That is not jnana. There are going to be issues processing it. Therefore, tarka is important. It cannot be done away with. In fact, those who do away with tarka, there is jnana bhranti. I'll be very upfront. There is a jnana bhranti. As Pooja Swami says, there is the ignorance is just one question away. Others become a nimitta to reveal the ignorance that we have. And this is true in the worldly as much as it is in the spiritual. So you have to apply and see whether or not I understand. The Manana Grantha, entire Bhashya, Tika level, the charcha is not for the benefit of someone else, and people misunderstand. Why don't need all that? Why? Because their Bhagwan Bhashyakara or Tikakara is showing their own knowledge. It is all ego in establishing our Siddhanta over others. That's not the truth. The truth is it is a Manana Grantha. All Bhashya and Tika are Manana. Vichara Sagara, they are all Vichara. Vichara is Manana. It uses Tarka. You cannot have Vichara without Tarka. So the other's perspective are our buddhigata perspectives. Our errors are shown by the Purva Pakshi. If there were no division in the text as who is the Purva Paksha and who is the Siddhanta, there would be extreme difficulty in understanding any Grantha of the Siddhanta also. We do not know which is the Purva Paksha because Purva Paksha seems right. Why? Because these are our understandings also, misunderstandings. These are taken away by the responses. We should hold on to the responses, but it is not that we give away the tarka completely. Anyway, with that background, let's look at it. We have to have some tarka. And this book, this grantha, does not use much of tarkika language. Jargon is very much simple. It is plain Sanskrit and it is also plain Vedanta. There is not much of Tarkika's language per se. But we should still understand. Understand? At that level at least we should understand. So looking at the Khyati, where did it start? It started with, as there was a question, it started with the Samsara being Dukkha Rupa. What is the Samsara? Samsara is that which binds me. Freeing oneself from Samsara is Moksha. How do you free yourself from samsara? And why do you want to free yourself from samsara? Because there is dukkha in the samsara. इफ द संसार हैज दुखा एंड माय परस्यूट ईच एंड एवरी पर्सन इज लुकिंग फॉर सुखा देन द सुखा बीइंग इन द विषय इन द संसार आई क्रेव टुवर्ड्स दैट काइंड ऑफ संसार विषय And there is a misconception that the sukha is in the vishaya. Because if had it been in the, had sukha been in the vishaya, then it should be all the time and for everyone. Neither it is the same vishaya, neither does the same vishaya give sukha to everyone, nor does one continue to derive sukha from the vishaya as long as the vishaya is there. We saw that with the example which one cannot refute. Because everyone loves their child. There is no parent who does not love the child, especially the mother. But here the example of the father is also given because culturally parents love their children. We forget about the, I mean, let aside the modern setup where there is no culture. Traditional upbringing will keep that family attachment alive. That attachment is Shuddha. It is a society of duties, not only responsibility, not only rights. You know, today unfortunately society is moving towards rights and you know, ignoring all the responsibilities, duties. But dharmic society, Vedic society is based on more on duties than on rights, because rights are given by what is due to you comes through karma. People don't hanker after this. That's the teaching of the Gita Shastra also. You do what is right to be done right now. What is due to you will be given anyway. Because Ishvara is karma phala data. Nobody is going to give you any karma phala. So even if you say, hey, this is my right, nobody is going to give you anything. It is only by Ishvara that you get everything. Thereby, what holds you from focusing on duties instead of hankering after rights? There should be nothing holding back, but still there is misconception and one wants sukha. Therefore, all the karma is towards sukha. That sukha isn't there in the vishaya because the vishaya continuing, the putra who has gone away, example given was putra who has come from a long trip. He was separated from the parents for a good while. When he comes back, there should be sukha. Not only in that moment, but it should continue to be there as long as Putra is there. But we don't see that happening. Therefore, Vishaya Sukha isn't there. And this is like a Prathama Malla Nyaya. Since there is no Sukha even in the Putra, then how can there be Sukha in anything else? That is the Prathama Malla Nyaya here. Putra is an example to refute every Vishaya Sukha. Because Putra is... it is called a Gauna Atma. In Putra, there is Atmatva Bhava. In other Vishayas, we don't have Atmatva Bhava. Not much. There is some extended. Mamakara is there. Ahankara is not there. But in Putra, there is Ahankara. Putra or Putri. Putra is an Upalakshana. There is an Ahankara. Ahankara there. Ahambhava is there. That is Gauna Atma. What we consider ourselves as, we consider our children also as the same thing. That's why putre tushte aham tushtaha. A parent cannot look at the child's dukkha because there is association by ahankara, not mamakara, not mama putra, but ahankara is there within. At least till a certain age, there is ahankara. Because there's gaunatvam, gauna bhava, gauna bhavena atmatvam is there. When there itself there is no sukha, continuing sukha, nityattvam, we are looking at nityattvam. If sukha is there by swarupa, then it should be nitya. If it is not nitya, it is not the swarupa. It is not swabhava, swarupa or swabhava means it is not there at all. Something, some sukha has come from elsewhere. What is that elsewhere? That source is you, says the guru. He says, in atma there is never samsara, never dukkha. You are always mukta, because mukti that one is searching for is what? Nitya mukti, which is paramananda prapti and atyanta dukkha nivritti. Guru told Tattva Drishti that you are already atyanta dukkha nivrittaha and you are already paramananda praptaha. You are already one who has Paramananda as your very Swarupa, Raho Shiravat Shashti. You are of the nature of Paramananda. You don't have any samsara. There is no sukha in Vishaya. There is no dukkha in you. To this, Tattva Drishti asks, how can there be no dukkha in samsara? I understand that I am Paramananda Swarupa, but I still don't see how there is nothing in the prapancha that gives me ananda, because sambandha, vishaya sambandha gives me sukha. There is sukha pratiti, and when it goes away, there is dukkha. So there has to be some kind of sukha in the vishaya also. There, the analysis is given. It is like the prapancha itself is not there, let alone the sukha in the prapancha. The prapancha does not exist. Kalatraya api nasti. Now this is shocking. Kalatraya api nasti. Yes, atmani nasti. Brahmatmani nasti. It is not there in the Brahmatma. It is not there in you. Who is that tvam? That tvam is not Tattva Drishti, who is this Trailokya Rajaputra. He is that Shuddha Atma without the koshas, without the Shariratraya, without the Pancha Koshas, without the Shariratraya. That Atma is Brahma. In that Brahmatma, there is no samsara, there is no Kalatrayapi, samsara nasti, therefore samsara dukkha nasti. To this, the question is, what is the example? He says, like the sarpa which is nitya nivrutta in the rajju. That is the example given, and then we have inquired into example as to what are the possibilities, because example has to be understood to understand the exemplified. If I tell you something is like, you know, how are things here, you know, if you ask something about in India, somebody is coming up from, say, US, and he asks, you know, in India, what is the law regarding this particular thing? If I answer, say, I tell him he's from US, and I say that the law is same as it is in, let's say, in UK. He does not know UK law. So it is not a convincing argument if you give an example which is unknown to the person. Therefore, here, example, Rajju Sarpa. How does Sarpa appear in Rajju? This has to be inquired into and agreed upon for the exemplified. The Brahmatma, samsara appears in Brahmatma to be understood. Thereby, we saw at Khyati Vada as to what are the different ways that Sarpa is seen in Rajju. Whether it is real or unreal, whether it is there or elsewhere, and then what is the jnana of Sarpa. In this, we looked at the four khyatis. So, in the four khyatis, we looked at who says what, who agrees with a particular khyati is not that important. It is all technical. In the khyati also, what is it? Whether the sarpa is real and elsewhere. If it is elsewhere, how does it appear here? So, someone says that it is elsewhere and it appears here. Anyatha khyati. First, Bauddha Vada, two Bauddha Vadas. One is Shunya Vada, the other is Kshanika Vijnana Vada. So, one says that it is Asat Khyati. Asat Khyati means the Sarpa is not there, Rajju is also not there. Shunya Vada, nothing is there, it just appears. To that, the next Bauddha himself asks, Kshanika Vijnana Vadi, how can something which isn't there appear? Vandyaputra we never see. We don't see Gagana Pushpa. So, how can there be Asat, Atyanta Asat, and have Pratiti? And this is in the Vyavaharika Satta, not a Paramarthika Satta. In Paramarthika Satta, we'll say everything is unreal, completely. Atyanta, Atyanta Asat. In the Paramarthika perspective, which is the real perspective, we have to land there. But in Vyavahara, we say there is a Pratiti. How can there is a Pratiti? So, the Kshanika Vijnana Vadi says there is a Pratiti because the Vijnana, Chaitanya itself transforms into Sarpa. It also transforms into Rajju. So in Vyavaharika Satta, they say, again in Vyavahara, not in Paramarthika. In Paramarthika, we'll say there is nothing. Nothing other than Atma. But the Kshanika Vijnanavadi says that Chaitanya transforms itself into each and every Padartha that you see. It is Jnana, it is consciousness itself transforming. Which is again Siddhanta. Siddhanta does not say that consciousness transforms. Second, they say that it is Kshanika. We say Vritti is Kshanika, but Chaitanya is not Kshanika. They say that Chaitanya is Kshanika and appears in the form of the Prapancha. In the case of Rajju Sarpa, Sarpa. Then if in the exemplified, they say the same Vijnana, Kshanika Vijnana appears as Rajju also. This is the entire samsara. But there is a disconnect. How can there be two units of Kshanika Vijnana between which there is nothing? Between which what is there? There is nothing to connect the earlier and the next. There has to be something in between. Otherwise, there will be no Pratya Vijna. There will be disconnect between the earlier and the latter. There will be no continuation. But there is continuation. The continuation can be a Bhranti. We agree. Like a flicker, you know. In childhood, we used to have these books like called flicker. You have pictures drawn like a cartoon, you know. You draw and then there are a series of pictures. You know, just go through all the pages. As a flicker, you flick the pages and you see this cartoon is moving. Just like how the film takes place. Any movie is basically a set of pictures thrown at you at a certain rate. You know, whatever, 25 or 30 frames per second. There can be a Bhranti, we agree, but there has to be something between the two. There is a Bhranti of continuity, but in the Prapancha there can be, in Vrittis there can be a Bhranti of continuity, but there has to be a continuous principle backing it, which lends that continuity to the, who is a witness of this continuity at least. Between one and the other, there has to be someone to witness that at least. They do not agree. Therefore, in their setup, they cannot explain the continuity. Pratyabhijna cannot be explained. And the other ways also. I am explaining in a simpler way. Then, the Anyata Khyativadi comes in. Vaisheshika and Nayayikas, they come up and they say, there is Anyata Khyati. What is Anyata Khyati? The old school of Nyaya. They say that Anyata Khyati means Anyata. Anyata means Anyaprakarena. Anyaprakara is what? Rajju is in front of you, Sarpa is elsewhere in the Sarpa Bila, Valmika Gata Sarpa elsewhere, but Chakshu is connected to that. Chakshu is able to see a far placed Sarpa, but Anyatha means that Sarpa which is elsewhere is seen here and now. So Anyatha, Anya Prakarena means Deshantara. Deshantare pratitihi sarpasya is anyata khyati there. So to that the navya nayayika, the new school of nyaya comes up and the logician himself questions the other old logician. He says, how can you miss everything that is there in the surrounding of the sarpa in another desha, another place, where your eyes are connected? You say only the Sarpa is seen, not the Sarpa Bila Ityadi. Everything else is ignored, only Sarpa is seen, and that is somehow ported here, you see here. That is one objection. Second objection is, how can you miss everything in the line of sight? If the eyes are connected to the Sarpa Bila, then the Vritti which is taking place in the line of sight, everything that is there in between, how can you miss those things also? They also should be seen here. Thereby, because you do not see anything else in the Sarpadesha and you do not see anything else between where you are and where the Sarpadesha is, you do not see anything in between. Therefore, your khyati is wrong. It is Anyatha, all right, but the interpretation of Anyatha is wrong. It is not Anyadeshe. Anya Desha, meaning Anya Prakarena, Deshantarasya Deshantare. दैट इज नॉट अन्यथा, अन्यथा इज दिस रज्जु सर्परूपेण भाति, दैट इज अन्यथा, रज्जु अन्यथा भाति, दैट इज अन्यथा ख्याति. हाउ? नो आंसर टू दैट. टू दैट दी अख्यातिवादीन कम्स इन, द फोर्थ ख्यातिवादा विच इज सांख्यास फॉलोड बाय सांख्यास एंड प्राभाकरास, प्राभाकर मीमांसका. सो द प्राभाकर कम्स एंड सेज, हाउ इज इट पॉसिबल दैट ज्ञाना इज टेकिंग प्लेस ऑफ सर्प वेर एज इन योर इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू देर इज रज्जु. सो पदार्थ एंड पदार्थ ज्ञान देर इज अ डिस्कनेक्ट. And what is the principle accepted by everyone or should be accepted? Because it's Vastu Tantra, you do not have a choice to see something differently. In karma, you have a choice. But in jnana, you do not have a choice. Jnana is in keeping with Vishaya. If there is Brahma also, that for Brahma has to be explained. How did it take place? That is the Khyati Vada here. So, the Nyadhina Jnanam. Jnana is dependent on Nyaya Vastu. Nyaya is Rajju and Jnana is Sarpa. Sarpa Jnana. Whereas Nyaya is Rajju in front of you. How can you have Sarpa Jnana in your Antakkaran, in your Buddhi, whereas you say that there is Rajju in front of you? So, Anyata Khyati is not right. You cannot have anyatha from what? From Rajju. Rajju anyatha sarpakhyati is not right. Sarpajnanam. Meaning what? Rajju vishayaka sarpajnanam is not right. How can Rajju vishayaka sarpajnana cannot have vishaya as Rajju? There has to be vishaya as sarpa itself. Therefore, your anyatha khyati is not right. Then what is the right khyati? Prabhakara says the right khyati is very simple. Akhyati, there is no khyati, there is no misunderstanding, there is no knowledge which is wrong. It is all pramarupa jnana. One is, but unfortunately, it is not a single unit of jnana. He says there are two units of jnanas. So, what is the reality? He says there is Rajju in front of you. And there is Sarpa, which is in Smriti. You recall the Sarpa due to whatever reason. There is Bhaya Ityadi. There is Sarpa. There is Sarpa Smriti. And there is Rajju in the front. So Rajju, there is. This is a Rajju. This is a rope. That is one unit of knowledge, which is Pramarupa, which is valid knowledge. Then there is another unit of knowledge which is Aham Sarpam Smarami. I recall the Sarpa. That is another unit of knowledge. But due to Pramatra Dosha, Pramana Dosha, all these doshas, there is a confusion. What is that confusion? One does not know that I have two units of knowledge and both merge into one another. So there is Idam, Aumsha of the Rajju, which is known. But Sarpa Amsha of the Smriti is mixed up there. And thereby one says, Ayam Sarpaha. Instead of saying, Iyam Rajju, one says, Ayam Sarpaha. Says and one thinks that. This is the Akhyati. To this, there is a question as to, I mean, here also the question is, how can one have Bhaya and run away? One does not have a feeling that I recalled, I had fear. When I saw the Sarpa, I had fear, but fear is here and now. And one runs away from Rajju. Wherever one runs away, there should be fear there also, because in the Buddhi there is Sarpa. That does not take place. Therefore, because of Bhaya being there, Palayana, from the place of the Rajju, not the Sarpa, one should discount this Akhyativada also, because there is Sarpa seen in the Brahmasthala, not in the Buddhi. And technically, you cannot have two Vishesha Jnanas together. What are the two Visheshas? One is a Pratyaksha Vishesha, other is a Smriti Vishesha. One is Anubhava Rupa, the other is non-Anubhava Rupa Jnana. Both are Jnanas. You cannot have two Jnanas simultaneously. Vishesha Jnanas. Pratyaksha, Rajju or Idamamsha also. Idamamsha Pratyakshatvena is a Vishesha Rupa Jnana and Smriti of Sarpa is also Vishesha Rupa Jnana. You can have a Samanya and Vishesha together. You cannot have two Vishesha Jnanas simultaneously. Thereby, too many issues with Prabhakara Mata also. Now, if all these are refuted, then Tattva Drishti asked, okay, all these are erroneous, what is the reality? What is the Siddhanta then? In fact, he asked, which is the best Mata among these four? So, across all these four refutations, we have seen none of these are valid. That's what the Guru said, none of these are valid. There is another called as Anyatha Khyati. Called Anirvachaniya Khyati. This is a Siddhanti. Siddhanti says there is Anirvachaniya Khyati. Anirvachaniya means what? Anirvachaniya. Anirvachaniya means Sadvilakshana as well as Asadvilakshana. Meaning it cannot be categorized as Sat or Asat. What cannot be categorized? The Sarpa in front of you. There is Sarpa. Is there a Sarpa? I cannot say yes. If had there been a Sarpa, then everyone would see. Everyone does not see. But even if you take Eka Jeeva Vada, is there a Sarpa outside? There are no others. Who will confirm whether there is Sarpa there or not? I say there is a Sarpa. But then I myself shine the light on the Sarpa and I see it is not Sarpa, it is Rajju. Then this Sarpa which will be later Badhita is not real. It is not Prama Rupa Jnana, it is Brahma. Therefore, Sarpa cannot be real. Because Sat is what? Trikala Badhita Sat, which cannot be counted in all the three periods of time, is Sat. However, this Rajju in front of me is seen as Rajju later, but it is seen as Sarpa now. Meaning, Sarpa is going to be refuted later. It is going to be sublated by Rajju Jnana. Therefore, it is not Sat. Can it be Asat? It is not Asat. Otherwise, I will never see Sarpa. Forget about others. Even if there are no others, I will never see Sarpa if there is no Sarpa at all. Then what is it? It is Sadvilakshana. To this, the Purva Pakshi asked, how can you say Sadvilakshana and Asadvilakshana together? Sadvilakshana means Asat. Asatvilakshana means Sat. You have to say either. You cannot say both. To this, the Siddhanti explained. This was in the Tippana though. Sadvilakshana, what is Sat? Sat is Trikala Badhita Sat. Sadvilakshana means it is Badhita in one of the periods of time. Meaning in future it will be refuted, it will be sublated. That is the meaning of Sadvilakshanatvam, not Asat. Asat would mean like Vandhyaputra. Atyanta Asat. That is the meaning of Asat. Therefore it is Sadvilakshana but not Asat. But you said Asadvilakshana also, yes. Asat Vilakshana means Vandya Putra Vat Asat Atyanta Asat Vilakshana. It is different from Atyanta Asat. That is not Sat because what is different from Atyanta Asat can be there in any which way. That can be anything which has a Pratiti. Need not be Sat which is Trikala Badita Sat. Thereby it is Sat Vilakshana as well as Asat Vilakshana. What is this category? The category is called as Mithya, Anirvachaniya, Sadasadhyam, Anirvachaniya, Mithya, Rupa Khyati is Anirvachaniya Khyati. Now, not only the Padartha is Asat, I mean Anirvachaniya, Sadvilakshana, Asadvilakshana, Sadasadvilakshana, the Jnana also is Sadasadvilakshana, Mithya, Anirvachaniya. We won't have the issues that the others face. Which are, you know, Palayana, how can there be Bhaya and Palayana? Yes, there is Bhaya and Palayana from that place because there is Anirvachaniya Sarpa there as Padartha. There is Anirvachaniya. Why don't the others see? Because it is Anirvachaniya. What do you mean because it is Anirvachaniya? Because it is Anirvachaniya, there is Sarpa Utpatti only for this specific person. There is no Sarpa Utpatti for others. How can it be so? Anirvachaniya. We cannot say how. Anirvachaniya also means inexplicability. We cannot explain. Everyone has tried. Everyone has tried to explain, and there are flaws. So we say we cannot explain. Why? Because this is Ishwari Maya, which is called as Avidya. It is a Shakti. It has Avarna Shakti and Vikshepa Shakti. You cannot say that everything should be explained the way I understand. It cannot be explained. It has to be understood the way it is. How it is? It is Sat. During the period of perception, it is Sat. When the jnana of the Rajju as Rajju comes up, then it is Asat. Therefore, it cannot be called as Sat or Asat. It cannot be called as Sat and Asat also. You cannot, because they are mutually contradictory. Therefore, the only way it can be explained, it is not Sat, not Asat. It is neither Sat nor Asat. So if you ask, no, you tell me. And this is the others. They say, no, you tell me how it is. We are saying you cannot, because Shruti has not said. How can we say Shruti has said that everything other than Brahma is non-existent? Do you agree it is non-existent? We don't have any arguments at all. No, we want to know how can there be pratiti of non-existent. Cannot be explained. Ishwari Maya, Avidya. But technically if you analyze, yes, we say there are two Shaktis. One is Avarna Shakti, the other is Vikshepa Shakti. Avarna Shakti hides the Tattva. So Rajju, in the Brahmastala, Rajju is hidden by Avarna Shakti of Avidya, otherwise called Maya. And then there is Vikshepa Shakti which projects. These are simultaneous now. The Padartha which comes up, Vikshepa Rupena, because Rajju Avarna is there, the Sarpa Vikshepa, Avidya Karya which comes up, that is possible only due to this Shakti of Avarna which covers the Rajju. Rajju not being covered, you cannot have Vikshepa. Even if there is Vikshepa, one will not take that Vikshepa is real. In the case of a Jnani, for example. You know, one may analyze, after looking at the Rajju, one may analyze, look at the characteristics, attributes of this shape, shape and attributes, eyes, all that you see in this snake. But it's a Mithya snake. There is Atyanta Asat snake there. When Rajju is known as Rajju. But still one may analyze, does it not look like a snake? Look at, you know, these are eyes. Look at these like fangs. They appear so. But one knows that it is not a snake at all. So Vikshepa will not harm you. Avarna harms you. Avarna, which is the cause for Vikshepa, which is the reason for the Vikshepa to appear as real, harms us. Bhaya is due to the reality given to the Vikshepa, which is possible only due to Avarna. And Sarpa Jnana, Sarpa Padartha are in sync, because Avidya Karya is simultaneous within and without. Outside, it is an Avidya Karya, which is Tamapradana Avidya, which is resting on the Chaitanya, which is Rajju Avachinna. Whereas within, there is Vikshepa Karya, Avidya Karya, which is Sarpa Jnana. That is also Avidya Karya, but it is Sattva Pradhana Avidya Karya, which is Antakarana Nishta. In the case of Bhranti, it is Sakshi Chaitanya Nishta. Sakshi Chaitanya is a Upadhi. Sakshi Chaitanya, not Antakarana is an Upadhi otherwise. Sakshi Chaitanya Nishta Avidya, because it is Sakshi Bhasya. In Swapna and in Pratibhasika Satta, there is Sakshi Bhasya Padartha, Sakshi Bhasya Jnana also. Vritti is lit up by the Sakshi. And Sakshi Chaitanya, Sakshi is Chaitanya. Sakshi Chaitanya has Avidya. That Avidya, which is Sattva Pradhana now, converts itself into Jnana. Which Jnana? Sarpa Jnana. Outside, Tamav Pradhana Avidya, which is Rajyavachinna Chaitanya, Nishta Avidya, that Avidya, Tamav Pradhana San, Sati. Tamav Pradhana Sati, it gives a Vikshepa. And that Vikshepa is Avidya Karya, which is Vishaya, Sarpa Vishaya. So Sarpa Vishaya has come up, Anirvachaniya Sarpa Vishaya, and Anirvachaniya Sarpa Jnana has taken place simultaneously within, which is Sakshi Bhasya. Then one says, that there is Sarpa outside. I know this Sarpa, and one has Bhaya and one runs away. This is the setup. When Rajju Jnana takes place, what happens? Then Rajju Jnana taking place, this Sarpa Padartha goes away and Sarpa Jnana goes away simultaneously again. How? There is technicality here also. Because there is a question, you have said that Adhishtana for both is Chaitanya. Chaitanya is the Adhishtana, Rajju is not the Adhishtana. Because Avidya Karya outside and Avidya Karya inside. Meaning Avidya Karya is Sarpa Vishayaka outside and Avidya Karya is Sarpa Jnana within. Both are Avidya Karya, both are resting on Chaitanya. Outside it is Rajya Avachinna Chaitanya, inside is Sakshi Chaitanya. Both are Chaitanya. Chaitanyas are a single unit. There is no division. Ghata Akashavat Abhinna. So Chaitanya outside and within are one. But they are divided as though due to Upadhis. Antakkarana Upadhi inside and there is Rajju Upadhi outside. Now if Avidya Karya, both are Avidya Karya, and for Avidya the Adhishtana is Chaitanya, then how can you have Rajju which is non-Adhishtana? How can you have non-Adhishtana Rajju Jnana which leads to Sarpa Nivritti and Bhaya Nivritti Ityadi, Palayana Nivritti, all that? Sarpa Nivritti and Sarpa Jnana Nivritti should take place by Adhishtana Jnana. Adhishtana Jnanena Adhyasa Nivritti. What is Adhyasa? The Jnana as well as Vishaya. Brahma Vishaya as well as Brahma Jnana is called as Adhyasa. Atasmin Tadbhava is Adhyasa. That is the definition. Atasmin, in non that, in non Sarpa, seeing Sarpa. Seeing Sarpa in a non-Sarpa, Atasmin, Asarpe, Tad Buddhi, Sarpa Buddhi is Adhyasaha. In what kind of a Atasmin, Asarpe, Rajjau, Atasmin, Asarpe, Rajjau, but Rajju is not the Adhishtana. In the place of Rajju, one is seeing something, but really where is one seeing? There is nothing other than Chaitanya. Chaitanya is the Adhishtana. Now, Adhishtana Jnanena Adhyasa Nivritti is the Siddhanta, Advaita Siddhanta. So, Purvapakshi says, you are contradicting your own Siddhanta. How can you say that Rajju Jnanena, Anadhishtana Rajju Jnanena, Adhyasa Nivritti, Sarpa Nivritti? How can you say that? Because Adhishtana is Chaitanya. Then you should say what? Chaitanya Jnanena Adhyasa Nivritti. Meaning Chaitanya Jnanena Sarpa Nivritti, Chaitanya Jnanena Rajata Nivritti, Chaitanya Jnanena Chaura Nivritti in the Stamba. All this in the Brahmasthala, everywhere you should say Brahma Nivritti, Adhyasa Nivritti. How does it take place? Chaitanya Jnanena. Siddhanti says, I have no issues there. Why? Because Rajju Jnana, Shuktika Jnana, or the Stamba Jnana is all what? Chaitanya only. Because Jnana is Chaitanya. We do not have anything else. We follow the Shruti completely. Shruti says Satyam Jnanam Anantam. Jnanam there is Chaitanya. It is not Karaka Rupa Jnana. It is not even Bhava Vritti. Bhave Vyutpatti, Jnanam, Nyadhatu, Shuddha Nyaptihi. Bhagavan Bhashyakara says in Taittiriya under the Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, he refutes all the Karakarthas for Jnanam Shabda and then he says Lut Pratyanta, Jnanam, Jnana plus Lut is Jnanam. There the Jnanam Shabda has Lut Arthas. Lut Arthas are what? Possible. Lut Arthas are generally what? Bhave Karane Adhikarane cha. So Karnakaraka, Adhikarnakaraka, then there is Bhavi Vyutpatti Shuddha Dhatvartha. So Bhagavan Bhashyakara refutes others also. Akarmani cha karake sanyayam. Possible. Akartari, sorry. Akartari cha karake sanyayam. Akartari. Non-karta, all other meanings can be there. So there can be karma meaning. Karana anyway it is there. There can be sampradana meaning. There can be upadana. sorry, apadana, apadana, then apadani panchami, then there can be shashti sambandha anyway, not a karaka, saptami adhikarana. So karane adhikarane bhave is there in lute itself, but then if you take another sutra, akartari cha karake sanyayam, akartari artha, non-kartha artha, all other karakas can be there. In fact, non-karakas also can be there. Akartarice karake sanyayam. It is possible. Other meanings, karakarthas can be there. One may misunderstand non-karaka also. Whatever it is, at least karaka meanings can be there. Some karane adhikarane, if nothing else. It is not a karane artha. Jnana does not mean bhave vipatti knowledge. It does not mean that through which you know. It is not means of knowledge. Atma. It is not the adhikarana of knowledge, buddhi. And other meanings also. It is not the source of knowledge. It is, none of these are really applicable. What is it? Then nyapti, shuddha jnana swarupa, shuddha dhatvartha. For that, Bhagavan Bhashyakara uses tin pratya, nyapti. Strilinga shabda gives a strilinga shabda in which meaning? Same meaning, bhavya yutpatti. When you explain one krut with another krut, pratyaya, using one krut with another krut, especially in this lut with thin or thin with lut, then it is bhavya vyutpatti. You cannot explain with a verb. So it is bhavya vyutpatti. Bhavya vyutpatti means shuddha dhatvartha. But shuddha dhatvartha, it cannot be because there is a purva paksha to that nya dhatu is sakarmaka dhatu. It has dependency. But chaitanya does not have any dependency. Therefore, the meaning of nyapti, meaning bhava sadhana, meaning bhava vyutpatti, meaning shuddha dhatvartha also should be dropped. What do you land on? Finally, chaitanya, chit swarupa brahma. That is the meaning, that is the lakshana. And jnanam means chaitanya. This is the definition from Vedanta Paribhasha also. Siddhantetu, says the Vedanta Paribhasha. Siddhantetu, jnanam chaitanyam eva. Jnana is chaitanya. So if you say adhikarana jnanena, adhishthana, not adhikarana, adhishthana jnanena, adhyasa nivritti should be chaitanya jnanena adhyasa nivritti. We do not have any issues. Why? Because rajju jnana, shuktika jnana is chaitanya, shuddha rupa chaitanya. Because what is our prakriya? When the vritti goes out, it takes away that vishesha jnana. When vishesha jnana goes away, what remains is chaitanya. The chaitanya within and without are not different. Example given is like the water which flows out and takes the shape of the field, whichever is the akara of the field is taken up by the water as in the example literally. It does not cross the boundary. So if there is a field, let's say there is a rice field which is circular in shape, then the water takes the circular shape. If it is triangular, it takes triangular shape, hexagonal, hexagonal, square, square, rectangular, rectangular. However is the shape of the field is taken by the water. Similarly is the vritti. Now, when you have opened up your, you know, in the village side, you have opened up a tap or a pump set, whatever you have opened up so that the water flows out to the field. What is the difference between the water in the field and the water here? This water is connected there. How will you know? If you touch this water and someone drops, God forbid, someone drops an electrical wire there, then one will get a shock here. Why? Because the water here and there is not different. It is connected. It is the same water flowing in. That's what the flow, the source of the water is in the field. The same, the water and the source is in the field. It's the same water. Thereby, this chaitanya, which is the underlying principle which is pervading in the vritti, where avidya rests and vritti is going to take away that avidya, there the vritti which has gone out through the indriyas, chakshurindriya being what it is, it can only deal with chakshu vishayas. It can take away only chakshu vishaya ajnana. Now, if can take away only chakshu vishaya ajnana, that also which ajnana? Only where there is a vritti. If the vritti takes place with the chakshu vishaya, it does not take place with every vishaya. It is only that vishaya that it can reach. In the parvataha vanniman, parvata has fire. The mountain has fire. In that example, I do not see the fire, but I infer the fire. What do I see? I see smoke. Why dhumat? Because I see dhuma. I see smoke. My chakshus are able to reach the dhuma but not the vanni. Therefore, I can see only dhuma. There can be only dhuma vritti. And dhuma vritti, dhumakara vritti can take away only dhuma ajnana, not vanni ajnana. You cannot have one jnana taking away other jnana, other ajnana. You have to have one jnana, vishesha jnana can take away only vishesha jnana. Thereby, dhuma jnanena, dhuma jnana nivrittir bhavati, natu vanni ajnana nivrittihi. Therefore, vanni has to be inferred, anumanena, jnayate. Natu pratyakshena, pratyakshena na jnayate. Pratyakshena dhumaha jnayate. Similarly, in the Rajju Sarpasthana, when the vritti goes out and has the idamakara, let's take the non-brahmasthala. In the non-brahmasthala, when Rajju Jnana takes place, we have seen the brahmasthala. Brahmasthala, the idamakara vritti takes place. Rajju akara vritti does not take place. So, idamamsha is known, samanya. Visheshamsha is the sarpa, which is the sarpa jnana within. So, idamamsha and sarpa vishesha, idam samanya and sarpa vishesha become one unit of knowledge. One is samanya, the other is vishesha. We don't have the flaw of the akhyati vadin where there are two visheshas. One is pratyaksha, other is smriti. For us, both are one unit of knowledge because there are no two visheshas. One samanya and one vishesha is possible. In the Rajju jnana, what happens is Rajju, the chakshu is connected with the Rajju. When it does connect with Rajju, Chakshurindriya, which can see only Chakshu Vishaya, meaning only forms and colors, that Chakshurindriya can form the vritti of the shape, form or color. It cannot have a Shabdakara vritti. That Antakkarana which has gone out, which has Chaitanya, because the Antakkarana vritti which is forming is Chaitanya Nishta. Antakkarana Nishta which is Chaitanya Nishta. Avidya is Chaitanya Nishta. Everything is really Chaitanya Nishta. There is Rajju which is Chaitanya Nishta. Chaitanya Nishta is Chaitanya Avachinna. Rajju outside has Chaitanya. Antakkarana has Chaitanya which has gone out. So vritti has Chaitanya. Sakshi is Chaitanya Rupa. The Drashta is Chaitanya. Antakkarana avachinna. Then the vritti which has taken place now, which is Rajvakara, that Rajvakara jnana which takes place will take away. Vritti is jnana which takes place, that will take away Rajju ajnana. Where is this Rajju ajnana? Rajju ajnana is ajnana which is in the Rajju ajnana, meaning avidya, is in Chaitanya. Chaitanya has avidya, meaning what? It has avidya regarding everything. Whatever is known, that alone is known. Only that much avidya goes away. That is why we know only very few things. Most of the things that we don't know, I mean, not most of the things, anyone asks something, even in what we know, our ignorance is avidya is, ajnana is one question away. Pujya Swamiji says this, you know, one question away. So, an expert, a PhD will say, after 20 questions, he'll say, I don't know. An ajnani will say, the first question itself or second question, I don't know. That is our ajnana. It is in each and every vishaya we have ajnana. There seems to be Gaurava in this Paksha, but there is actually, if you look at the explanation that others gives, compared to that, there is Laghavam. We say the ajnana is as vast and covering Chaitanya. Avarana is on everything. That is why we have to take effort. We are not born with knowledge. Whatever knowledge we are born with is carried from the prior Janma. It manifests in Prarabdha. Due to Prarabdha, it manifests. But otherwise, there is Ajnana all over. But now, Ajnana, if you take any Vishaya, there is Ajnana regarding that. So, the Jnana regarding that Vishaya will take away only that Ajnana. This is called as Tula Ajnana. Tula. Mula Ajnana is Atma. Atma Ajnana. Brahma Ajnana is Mula Ajnana. Mula Vidya. Tula Vidya is related to a particular Vishaya. Rajju Vishayaka, Sarpa Vishayaka, Rajata Vishayaka, or the Shuktika Vishayaka Ityadi. Prapancha, in Prapancha, Ghata, Pata, Ghata Vishayaka, Pata Vishayaka, there is Ajnana all over. All this Ajnana is Chaitanya. Because there is Avarna, by this Shakti of Avidya, there is Avarna of each and every unit of knowledge, which is the Swarup of Chaitanya really. Then when this Vishaya, Vishayakara Vritti takes place, Rajvakara Vritti takes place, it will counter the Rajva Jnana. Rajju Ajnana. When it takes away Rajju Ajnana, then only the Rajju Ajnana is lit up. Rajju Vritti is lit up, sorry. Rajju Vritti is lit up, and that will show up only Rajju. I will not know Atma, I will not get Atma Jnana due to that. I will not get Pata Jnana, Ghata Jnana due to that. I'll not get any other Jnana, but only Rajju Jnana. Now this Sarpa Jnana, Jnana which has taken place earlier will be countered because Sarpa is no longer there. Rajju Jnana, which is Adhisthana Jnana because it is Chaitanya Rupa, Purvapakshi objective to that, we don't have any issue because Rajju Jnana is Chaitanya. Chaitanya shows up only that Rajju. Chaitanya Jnana is Rajju Akara because Chaitanya has Rajju Jnana also. Every Jnana is in Chaitanya, otherwise there cannot be a manifestation of Prapancha at all because Jnana Mayat Tapaha, and that Tapa is Bhausyam Tad Aikshata, first Aikshata. How can one Ishvara as Brahma maybe, Chaturmukha Brahma, how can he see, how could he have seen Aikshata? Aikshata Kriya cannot take place unless there is Jnana. Meaning Chaitanya has all this. Then it was recalled as it is in the prior Srishti, in the Antakarana, which is also a manifestation, and then the entire Prapancha is Srashta. Srashta Prapancha. What is that Srijana? Srijana is Jnana Rupa really. But anyway, assuming that there is a Srishti, what happens? The Chaitanya is Vivarta, does not modify itself, whereas what is modified is Avidya. Avidya is material cause, Parinami Upadana Karana, and Chaitanya is Vivarta. This is what we have seen so far. Therefore, Chaitanya Nivritti, Chaitanya Jnanena, that's what Adhisthana Jnana has to be Chaitanya Jnana as per the Purvapakshi. We say all Jnana is Chaitanya Rupa. So, Rajju Jnanena Nivritti, Sarpa Nivritti is Rajju Jnanena, when Chaitanya becomes one. This Chaitanya which is within and outside, he is one, Vrittigata Chaitanya is one. It is non-different from the Drashta Chaitanya, Drashtra Chaitanya, and it becomes non-different by the Ajnana veiling going away. Chaitanya underlying the Rajju becomes one with the Antakkarana Gata Chaitanya, Vrittigata Chaitanya, which is the Drashtra Gata Chaitanya, which is Drashtra Swarupa really. Then one knows the Rajju as Rajju. One says, Iyam Rajjuhu, and then Rajjum Aham Janami. This is the setup through and through in every Jnana unit. Therefore, Chaitanya becoming one, the Chaitanya which is underlying the Vishaya, becoming one with the Vritti, and the Drashta being one with the Vritti, because Vritti Gata Chaitanya, the Chaitanya all in the entire triad, Triputi is one, like the water flowing in the field. That example, where if it is clear, this also will be clear, that Chaitanya becoming one, and becoming one means it is already one, but the Ajnana taking away, it will take away only the Vishesha Ajnana, Jnana, Jnana Vritti will take away Vishesha Ajnana. Vishesha Jnana Vritti takes away Vishesha Ajnana, and that part of Chaitanya as though becomes one. Although it is one, it becomes one as though and then I know the Vishaya. Rajju is known. Once Rajju is known, the Sarpa Vishaya goes away. Sarpa Jnana also goes away because it has countered Avidya at both levels. It has countered the Vishaya also and the Jnana also. Therefore, Anirvachaniya Sarpa Vishaya goes away by Rajju Jnana, and then Anirvachaniya Sarpa Jnana goes away by Rajju Jnana again. Rajju Jnana is Adhishthana Jnana because it is all Chaitanya. This is the setup. I hope this is clear. We'll revisit only when it comes up in the text further in more detail. But this is what is Anirvachaniya Khyati. Now, will this remain in the mind? That was the question. That is up to you. Abhyasena tu Kaunteya. If you do not need it, well and good. But you should not have any questions. If you have questions, no, how is it possible? Then you need it. If it is not going to stay in the mind, more Abhyasa is needed. Please revisit over and over again. There is nothing else to do. For moksha, this is the only way. So if there are doubts, you revisit, ask questions. Other pakshas should not be your paksha. You should not own up others' doubts. That is the only pursuit. I mean, in the jnana pursuit, taking away the weeds, obstacles are taking away purva pakshas. These are our buddhigata samshayaha. If we have doubts, we have to deal with them. Whether it is the Purvapakshi presented as a Purvapaksha or our own is irrelevant. All Purvapaksha is our own buddhigata. Because Purvapaksha, Purvapakshi is all different, okay. But they are all buddhigata for someone, right? They also have dealt with the same Shruti that we have dealt with. How is it that they get doubts? For whatever reasons, breaking away from Sampradaya, whatever reason, they have doubts. Those doubts are unanswered for them. They have come up with their own answers. We refute those answers because they are against Shruti. If we take to this kind of a systematic approach, I don't think there is difficulty for this jnana to stay. Whether it is this Anirvachana Khyati or not, in the details or not, but still God is in the details. We should preferably know with details. If we do not know with the details also, it's fine as long as we do not have doubts as to how can that be possible. The impossibility, the idea of impossibility should go away. The idea of possibility should come up, sambhavana. Then one should land on anyatha anupapatti. Otherwise, it is just not possible. This is idamittham. This is how exactly it should be. Jnana should be in such a manner that there is no other possibility. That is why we are able to refute each and every purvapaksha, even if it is new. Because we know that there is only one way it is possible. There cannot be other ways. Other ways are, you know, you give in, you know, not important points. So you just say, okay, maybe that way. But in the main jnana, tattvamasi, there can be no compromise. Other things you can deal with the way you prefer as long as there are no doubts. I don't have an issue by saying that, these things don't stay in my mind is fine as long as you don't have any doubts with how can there be a possibility at all. So that's the recap. We'll continue and hope to cover up. Okay, so let's do the prayer and stop. I couldn't go ahead today because there were questions, and with questions I do not want to go ahead. The pace is not that important for me because this is all that I want to do. My target is not to finish the text. I want to finish the text so that most of us can get what the text is saying. So we'll go at the pace. If there are questions, we'll deal with them. So we'll take these kind of break classes if there are needed. Otherwise, we'll continue. I can understand that many do not ask questions, but then the couple of people who ask the questions, they have studied a lot. If they have questions, then I can assume that others may also have questions. They may not ask them or they may not come up. The questions may not come up. So, assuming that it helps others, I thought that I'll take this kind of a class today. Okay. Sukam Nityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Namurpyo Adhishtanam Buddhya Buddhyam Buddhir Ketu Nirvam Aparam Sarvedanti Vidyam Pratyak Paramaha Tadeva Hannamatvam Samatihi. The issue is that some people, don't feel they want to ask questions in public, or, they do not know how to frame the questions. So, this is understandable. But then feel free to, ask questions on the group or at the end of the class, however you prefer. If you do have questions, Or, you know, I'll in the context of others' questions, I'll try to answer. Okay, namaste.
हरि ओम।
Okay, good to know. It is helpful. Namaste.